It's Bullseye. I'm Jesse Thorn. Artists, the people who make stuff, are often influenced by the stuff they see or hear. And sometimes that thing is so great they wish they made it themselves. It happens so often we made a segment about it. It's called I Wish I'd Made That. Today, you're going to hear from Paula Poundstone. She's a legendary stand-up comedian, been in the game since 1979. She's appeared on pretty much every talk show. She's had recurring roles on TV, dozens of specials. But this is NPR, and we're talking about Paula Poundstone. So we're talking about Paula Poundstone of Wait, Wait, Don't Tell Me.
Paula, this week a bus driver in India was reprimanded for failing to collect a ticket from a passenger, even though the passenger was what?
Even though the passenger was a dog.
Close.
A bird.
Yes. What kind of bird?
A parrot.
Yeah, back up. More common.
A pigeon.
Yes, a pigeon. I'm amazed you knew that.
Of course I knew that.
These days, Paula's working on a bunch of other new stuff, too. She's hosting a podcast called Live from the Poundstone Institute, where she interviews experts and academics in front of a live studio audience. She's also the author of a new book called The Totally Unscientific Study of the Search for Human Happiness. In it, she explores and tries out pretty much every trick in the book to live a happier life. Stuff like taekwondo, reorganizing her house, and driving a fancy new car. When we asked her if there was any TV show or movie that she wishes she'd made, she had a quick answer. Bridesmaids from 2011. Maybe one of the best wedding movies ever? Anyway, take it away, Paula.
The first time I saw Bridesmaids, I saw it in a movie theater with my two daughters who were, you know, probably one was early 20s and one was a teenager. I did not want to go see it. I don't know why I knew this, but I knew it was like related to somehow this sort of frat humor kind of movies that sometimes don't do anything for me. I knew that it would be like a little bit gross. And I just said to myself, you know, I don't know. It's just not my type of humor, I said. But all my ideas about how I wouldn't enjoy it pretty much fell away in the first scene. The scene of the character Annie, the Kristen Wiig character, having sex with the really boyfriend was so damn funny. It's all about her trying to sexually please this guy, and she was so damn funny in it. Her legs sort of dangling about. I'm not usually like a huge sexual comedy kind of a character, but this was just so... It's, you know, Kristen Wiig just did it so brilliantly.
You slept over.
I did.
I thought we had a rule against that.
Oh.
I'm kidding.
Oh. That was funny. You're funny in the morning.
Wow, this is so awkward. I really want you to leave, but I don't know how to say it without sounding like a...
Probably the most notorious scene in Bridesmaids is the one where they are... they've gone into the very fancy wedding gown place, you know, by appointment only, and everything is all white.
Belle and Blanc, reservation name?
Oh, I don't have one. We're just here to shop, just to try on some dresses.
Okay, well, the next available appointment for bridesmaids fittings is in 7 weeks. Absolutely no walk-in.
And then they all have food poisoning, and they proceed to throw up and have uncontrolled bowel movements as a result. I mean, that alone would honestly not have done that much for me. But it was just what they were saying while it was happening that made it like, you know, a cut above.
You know, I don't really care which dress we get. It doesn't matter to me. I just need to get off this white carpet.
No, okay. God. No, not the bathroom. Everybody, go outside. I'm serious. There's a bathroom across the street.
Oh, I think we have to talk about the plane scene. Because one of the funniest lines in the movie ever said was in the plane scene.
I'm not a good flyer, I'm sorry. I had a dream last night that we went down. Yep, it was terrible. You were in it.
What?
Oh, God. Sounds like something's happening.
The character that the Annie character is very much in competition with is Helen. Helen has usurped, or appears to have usurped, Annie's role as the best friend of the bride. And this is, during the story, is that, you know, everything just keeps getting worse, but the biggest problem is that her friendship with her best friend is coming apart. So they're on their way to Las Vegas for the bachelorette party, And Annie's afraid to fly. And she's also broke. And her rival, the Helen character, is rich. So the Helen character is sitting in first class with the best friend, the bride. And Annie comes up to say, "Oh, I'm so nervous about flying." And the Helen character offers her some sort of, relaxant.
I have something. Take two, you'll fall asleep, wake up, and we'll be there. Here.
Oh. Ma'am, you're going to have to return to your seat, please.
And then she says, "Well, these aren't doing anything." And so the Helen character suggests to her that she wash it down with some whiskey. And so there's a powerful combination of inebriants now working.
Doing?
I'm good. I'm so much more relaxed. Thank you, Helen. I just feel like I'm excited and I feel relaxed and I'm ready to party with the best of them. And I'm gonna go down to the river.
And so Annie makes her way up again to first class, where the really snooty first class flight attendant, a guy named Steve, tells her that she has to go back to her seat.
What do you say?
Miss, you cannot be up here.
Hello, Grandpa.
This is a very strict plane that I'm on. Welcome to Germany.
As she walks back to the seat, first class has the silly curtains that go in between first class and the rest of the plane. And she opens the first class curtains and she says,
"This should be open because it's civil rights. This is the 90s.
Right. It's not. You're in the wrong decade.
You are.
Okay, I am.
You are.
Thank you.
Holy what did you give her?
So brilliant. So funny. And then, I don't know, Mitch Silpa is the guy who plays Steve. And I must say, part of what was funny, as in so many comedy performances, part of what was funny was how good Mitch Silpa was at being an
Miss?
No, it's not me.
Yes, it is you. Please go back to your seat.
Yes, I'm with him. I'm a Mrs. Iglesias?
No, you're not. You were just out here and you put sunglasses on. Out.
But I don't want to.
Excuse me. Right? Everybody go back to your seats.
Okay, you especially. You have 3 seconds to get back to your seat.
Oh, you can't get anywhere in 3 seconds.
Well, you better try.
You're setting me up for a loss already.
Okay, thank you.
I mean, part of what was joyous about that cast and those performances were just sort of how far they were willing to go. You know, the scene with Melissa McCarthy, who comes in and Annie is depressed on her couch and hasn't, gotten up and functioned for days.
I don't have any friends. The last time I
find interesting about that, Annie? Here's a friend standing directly in front of you trying to talk to you, and you choose to talk about the fact that you don't have any friends.
You know what I mean?
No, nope. I don't think you want any help. That's I think you want to have a little pity party.
No.
Yeah, I think Annie wants a little pity party. Is that what you
want? And Melissa McCarthy starts wrestling her in this sort of psychodrama where she's pretending to be Annie's life.
Ow! You're an Annie.
My God, what are you doing?
I'm life, huh? Life bothering you?
I was a teenager in the 70s, so this part, and I was a screwed up teenager. So this, this sort of psychodrama way of healing or breaking through is not unfamiliar to me, which is part of what made it so damn funny.
And you won't do it. You just won't do it. You stop slapping yourself. Stop slapping yourself. I'm your life, Annie. Sorry. Nice hit.
I've never been a bridesmaid, and I would never want to be one. I've occasionally gone to weddings, but that's as far as I can go. It doesn't sound like fun at all to me. You know, weddings cause problems. So the story is about the build-up to the wedding, not specifically about the wedding, but a lot of the problems that are caused by weddings, I think, are during the build-up. It's always somehow the guest list offends somebody. Somebody wasn't on the guest. There's just always problems with weddings. I don't know why people have them.
You know what? Why can't you just be happy for me and then go home and talk behind my back later like a normal person?
I am happy for you, Lillian. I am very happy for you. I wish you well. I won't bother you anymore.
Kidding me?
Get back here! Stop! No, no! She does not get a party favor! She does not get a dog!
Oddly, even though people tend to think of it as the movie where, you know, they throw up and have uncontrollable bowel movements at one scene, it's also, it is layered.
Alan just took over everything, and this has been really hard to do without you.
I'm sorry.
Nope, I'm sorry. Sorry I kicked you out of my wedding. It's my fault.
No, it's my fault. I think I'm the one with the mental problems.
Yeah, wasn't it my turn to be crazy?
Yes.
The bride's supposed to be crazy,
technically,
right? You kind of stole all the crazy.
I out-crazied you.
If I was trying to talk somebody going into this movie, I would simply say that in my opinion, it's the funniest movie ever made. I wish they would do a remake of it and have me in it this time.
Paula Poundstone on the things she wishes she'd made. The 2011 movie Bridesmaids, starring Kristen Wiig, Maya Rudolph, and Melissa McCarthy. Paula's new podcast, Live from the Poundstone Institute, is up and going strong. Check it out on NPR One or wherever you listen to podcasts. One more day.